Hey you guys, it's your girl T, and yes, the other day was the BET Awards, and I did watch it from start to finish. I wasn't able to live tweet because my roommate has regular Time Warner cable. Because it's Time Warner cable, I'm not able to watch it at the same time as the East Coast people. Like when I lived in Minneapolis, I had Dish Network. So whenever the show started, I could watch it with the East Coast people. We would all be live tweeting together. But it sucks being out here on the West Coast if you don't have Dish or a satellite, because then you're stuck with West Coast time. I don't feel like live tweeting 2 to 3 hours after the fact. It just sucks. I just sat in my bed, pouted, and just watched the BET Awards by myself. But I had a good damn time. The BET Awards was funny. Nobody watches the BET Awards to get anything out of it, really. We mainly watch it for the cipher. What I will say, though, this year was cool. Uncle Snoop Dogg was hosting, and y'all know I love me some Snoop. So it was cool to see him on stage. I think the part that touched me the most during the BET Awards was when Dougie Fresh got up there. And he got the Lifetime Achievement Award, and he broke down crying. He said that his mother had just died 5 weeks before this. It was nice seeing Dougie Fresh getting his just dues and, you know, seeing them give him an award. And when he broke down crying about his mother, that touched me. I was crying right along with him because I don't know what I would do without my mom, you know, so I definitely feel him on that. Another part that I love was the cyphers. I think so many people on these different cyphers, they killed it. I was so proud of everybody. It was a lot of really good artists. I was shocked when I saw Snow the Product on there. Snow killed it. A few of my subscribers put me up on Snow about a year ago, and Snow did her thing, and when she got up there, she started rapping in Spanish and English. I was like, get it, you know what I mean? And then when she dropped that line talking about, I'll be damned if the only Latin rep is Jocelyn Hernandez, I was like, damn, did she just come for Jocelyn? Snow did her thing. I was proud of her. I'm glad she made her national television debut. She definitely deserves it. She's been putting in work. Her damn fans, they go hard for Snow the Product. They really be pushing her product all over Twitter because they're the ones who put me up on Snow, and I do enjoy her music and I do enjoy her videos. You can check her out on YouTube. She's up and coming. But there's a lot of artists that I saw on there that I was just really proud of and that they did their thing. I also love seeing Remy Ma and Papoose. They killed that verse. I was like, damn. When they sat there and named off every hip-hop couple, even though Wiz and Amber broke up and Ciara and Future not together, it was still a dope verse, and it was cool to see Papoose and Remy Ma up there doing their thing. So now let's go ahead and talk about the big old elephant in the room. Because while Snoop was up there, everybody was talking about the whole situation, the whole beef situation with Snoop Dogg and Iggy Azalea. So unless you've been living under a rock, these fools have been beefing for the past 3 days. So what happened is that a few days ago, Iggy was caught at the airport with no makeup on. And we all know Iggy looks kind of strange without her makeup. So Snoop decides to post up a meme talking about this is Iggy without makeup. And so when he posted that, that was shots fired. So Iggy was upset, and you know, Iggy stuck up for herself, like, you know, that's not cool. How you gonna try and talk about me, but you be in my face, and you said that I'm a good artist, and da-da-da-da. So they start going back and forth. It got so heated yesterday that Snoop ended up making a video and threatening her. I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys this exchange between Snoop Dogg, Iggy Azalea, and what everybody and their mama had to say about it on the internet and on Twitter. Go ahead and check out all these comments, memes, and tweets, and I'll come back with the rest of my commentary.
So says Ty. Say, bitch, you fucking with the wrong nigga. And your nigga better check you for what I do. You funky bitch. Yeah, you fucking cunt.
just read all the comments, memes, and tweets. So after everything went down, folks were picking sides. Even Iggy's boyfriend, Nick, had something to say about the whole situation. Nick is a basketball player, and Nick was really upset. And a lot of folks are trying to drag Nick, saying that, you know, Nick has no business stepping up to Snoop. Nick shouldn't say anything. First of all, Nick and Iggy have been together for well over a year. That's his woman. I don't give a damn if his woman is white or black. If that's your woman, if that's your man, if that's who you're sleeping with, you're supposed to have their back regardless of who it is. If Snoop came at my man and that's my dude, I'm not going to let nobody disrespect my dude. Just like if I'm with somebody and somebody's disrespecting me, I expect my dude to have my back. Why were people getting mad at Nick for saying something to Snoop about Iggy? People are like, oh, he's a Captain Save-A-Ho. He's only saying that because he's with a white woman. I don't care if Iggy was black. That's his girlfriend. He's supposed to take up for his girlfriend, point blank, period. So I give Nick props for defending his girlfriend. That's what he was supposed to do. Okay? Thank you. So anyway, so after all this was said and done, people were picking sides. A lot of folks were going in on Iggy. A lot of folks were supporting Snoop. You know, the whole situation was just a mess. TMZ was saying, you know, Snoop had no business threatening her and showing a picture of him with a gun. Other people were saying that it's just beef. If you don't like it, get off the internet. So everybody had an opinion about the whole situation. I just sat my ass on Twitter, poured me a nice hot cup of tea, added a little bit of sugar, stirred it up, and was just sipping away, taking my little screenshots, reading comments. So after Snoop put out that video threatening her, and they were trending all over Twitter, and folks were going in on Iggy, it was just so much drama yesterday. Finally, T.I. put an end to the foolishness. T.I. called Snoop. They had a big conversation, and basically T.I. forced Snoop to apologize to Iggy. I'm going to show you guys this new video of Uncle Snoop basically backtracking and apologizing to Iggy, and I'm going to show you guys Iggy's response as well. Go ahead and check out this mess.
Boys and girls, I just got off the phone with my homeboy Tip, the King of Atlanta, and it's officially over. No more bad talk. I apologize. Yeah, I apologize. I'm sorry. I won't do it again.
All right, so you guys just watched Snoop's apology to Iggy, and you guys just saw Iggy's response. So after Snoop apologized, a lot of folks were pissed off. They're like, you know what? You're supposed to be gangster. You're supposed to be the OG. You used to rap with Tupac. You used to be with Dre. Come on, you was part of Death Row. You don't apologize to Iggy Azalea. Who the hell is she? So a lot of folks was going off on Snoop for apologizing to her, but then in the same breath, disrespecting black women and never apologizing to black women. Even Azalea Banks was upset because she feels like the white media was taking up for Iggy, and she's like, well, hold up. Why was nobody defending me when T.I. threatened to throw me down the steps? Why was nobody, you know, having my back and seeing about my well-being when I got attacked and when I got attacked on Twitter by T.I.? So anyways, go ahead and check out all these responses and comments, and I'll come back with the rest of my commentary. To know my opinion on this entire foolishness. And my opinion is this: you can expect a Snoop Dogg and Iggy Azalea single, possibly featuring T.I. in the near future. I feel like this was all for publicity. I feel like this was just for them to get attention. They know what they're doing. I see through the bullshit. You know, but at the end of the day, the whole situation to me was just a mess. You know, I felt like, you know, the first meme, okay, yeah, that was kind of funny. But I felt like Snoop was kind of doing a little bit too much. You know, Snoop is an OG. He's been in the game forever. You know, he's been handling his business. A lot of folks love Snoop, from white people to black people to the street people to Hollywood people. Snoop is that dude out here. So I feel like Snoop don't really have to explain himself, nor did he have to go that hard at Iggy. And I feel like a lot of folks go at Iggy really hard is because she's from Australia, but she's trying to put on this hood persona, and a lot of folks don't understand that or respect that. So, you know, even Lord Jamar spoke about that. A lot of folks say that she's a culture vulture, and, you know, a lot of people are saying, oh, well, folks are just attacking her because she's a white woman. woman. And I don't think that that's necessarily the case, because a lot of folks don't really attack Eminem. They don't attack Yellow Wolf. They feel like Yellow Wolf, Eminem, you know, and all these other people, Mac Miller, that they're more authentic than Iggy. So I think Iggy gets a lot harder because they're trying to don her the new queen of, you know, hip-hop, the new queen of rap. And people feel like, well, hold up, how's she going to be the queen of anything when she's not even from America and she's not from the hood? Her lyrics don't match her upbringing. But, you know, at the end of the day, I feel like this was all a publicity stunt. I feel like it's for them to promote some type of single, some type of album. I just find it way too convenient that T.I. can call Snoop and then he can get on camera and hurry up and apologize. So, like I said, y'all mark my words, in the near future, there will be some type of collaboration with Snoop and Iggy, possibly featuring T.I. So anyways, go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire weird-ass, strange-ass beef that came out of nowhere featuring Snoop Dogg and Iggy Azalea. Were you team Snoop Dogg? Were you team Iggy? And then how do you feel about Snoop apologizing after T.I. made that phone call? Do you feel like Snoop sold out for apologizing to her? Or do you feel like Snoop was being a bigger person by apologizing to Iggy when he threw shots? And also, let me know your thoughts on the whole situation with Azalea Banks, because she's saying that, you know, she feels like it's not fair that everybody's taking up for Iggy and defending Iggy, but then nobody went at T.I. when T.I. threatened to beat her up and everything else. But my personal opinion with that is that at the end of the day, it wasn't like T.I. came out of nowhere and attacked Azalea. Azalea started attacking Tiny first, and then T.I. did nothing but defend his woman. And the same situation with Iggy. Iggy wasn't attacking Snoop. Snoop kind of came out of nowhere and attacked Iggy. And I also feel bad for the lady in the meme. You know, that's a real person, so I'm sure she probably feels like crap, like, damn, what are y'all trying to say, you know? So I just think the whole situation is just silly. Folks are too grown. Folks need to grow up. You know what I'm saying? Let the childish stuff go and just make it about the music and get y'all's money. So anyways, go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts. All right. Deuces.